Everyone, good evening and welcome to Spotlight. With me tonight, one of them is my dear friend of the whole Middle Eastern community, Dr. Kumar. And we have Sonny Reddy. Sonny, he's been with the community. He's attending a lot of events in the community. So welcome both of you to MEA.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you, Wally.
Sure. Sonny, tell me about yourself. Where did you grow up? What school you went?
First of all, marhaba.
Alhamdulillah.
London. So, I came from India. I grew up in India. My life. Parents were farmers. They didn't go to school. I'm the first person from my family to graduate from the college.
Great.
And my mom, more than my dad, my mother's dream is succeed. And she said, she worked so hard. She said, this hard work has to stop with us. Mm-hmm. You go. Educate
of the people who came to the United States is for a better future for their children.
Right.
That's why we all came here.
Right,
go ahead.
Right. So as a 20-year-old kid, I came to this country as a student.
Uh-huh.
And first I came to New York, was there for about a semester, and then I ended up meeting Dr. Ralph Kumbler. He was the chairman of the engineering department. And I was struggling. Student life was a very hard. Financially, I'd gone through so many troubles. And then within 1 year, I lost my mom.
Oh,
that was my biggest. She was the biggest inspiration. She mm-hmm. was my role model, and I lost her within 1 year. So what she used to tell me is, you know what? Don't ever give up. I don't care what you do. I want you to see succeeding. So I'm sure she might be in heaven and watching me today. So with the community help, I overcome and graduated in 1994. I worked everywhere, you name it, I worked any places across Detroit.
So which school you graduate from?
Engineering, I have a master's in chemical engineering.
From where?
Wayne State University.
Wayne State University.
University.
Dr. Kumar, we know a lot about you. You sit on the board of many hospitals, many schools. So, and I know a lot of people know you. But let me know a little bit about yourself. You know, where did you grow up, Dr. Kumar?
So, Ali, thank you again for having me back in this program. I love this program. I love your show. I love talking to you.
We love you.
Thank you. I grew up in Mumbai, which was Bombay, India.
Uh-huh.
And I went to Catholic school there.
Yes.
So my education has been pretty westernized right through.
Mm-hmm.
And then I went to medical school, following which I decided I need to come to America.
Okay.
The reason being that initially I thought I will stay in India and make India the education center of the world. But as you know, in Middle East and in India, things are different.
Yes.
And when you look at America, the US,
okay. mm-hmm.
and then Wayne State University was the first to offer me a research position because I had no visa, I did not have green card, I did not have any family members here.
I see.
And Wayne State offered me the green card, so they offered me a citizenship.
Wow.
They offered me a research position.
Mm-hmm.
Then they offered me urology residency because I needed training.
Yes.
And then as I was a urology resident, I met this wonderful person from West Branch, Michigan.
Yes.
She was a fourth-year student.
Uh-huh. Oh, wow.
And so I met her in April and married her in September of the same year.
Wow.
So in short, Wayne State also gave me a wife.
Great, great. So
life and wife.
Yeah. What hospital you work now, Dr. Kumar?
Two hospitals. One is Ascension Rochester, which used to be Crittenden Hospital.
Okay.
And now Henry Ford is
Ascension. Henry Ford bought a lot, yeah. Yeah.
And the other is Trinity Pontiac or Oakland, uh-huh. which used to be St. Joseph Pontiac.
I see.
So these are the main two hospitals I work now.
No.
Before COVID, I was at Troy Beaumont, the Beaumont system, then North Oakland, Troy, you know, the POH system, BMC.
Yes. Absolutely.
But I have now crystallized to these two hospitals.
I see. Sonny, tell me more about yourself. You're running for one state board of governor.
That's right.
Okay. You ever been involved in politics? Because to run for something, you should start with like in committees, small committees, and you know, from there you understand the system and all that, and then you're on. So right. Tell me about your experience.
So not directly, this is the first time I'm running for a position in America. but okay. I've been active in politics.
But do you work in committees, small committees?
I am a board of trustee in one of the organization, cultural organization. It's with 60,000 members on it. Uh-huh. It's a nationwide organization called American Telugu Association. I'm sitting on the board right now with that organization.
Okay. So. And what's your ambition if you went to that seat?
For the university especially, I'll tell you, I gone through the hardship of, especially with the tuition. Tuition is one-way skyrocketing. Mm-hmm. In fact, actually, a couple of weeks, actually, I went to school. And just like that, I sit down, I randomly pick the student, and I wanted to talk to them. I said, what do you think is the issues?
Yeah.
They told me two issues, mainly. One is tuition, of course. That's a number one priority. The schools are going up, and not many kids can afford. Their parents cannot afford. And the second one is, once they graduate, they're looking for advisory. They're not getting help. You know, I graduated 30 years ago from Wayne State. As an alumni, nobody approached me. I want to work with Dr. Kumar. I want to bring majority of the alumni, the successful alumni. There are so many of them doing a great business involved. Doctors are there. Attorneys are there. There is a successful business people are there. Yes. I want to bring them, I want to make them a partner in helping the students, either financially or being an advisor, being a mentor. There are many things we can do. That's my goal.
Yeah. Honestly, a lot of universities and colleges, like Lawrence Tech University, you know, the student, even before they graduate, they guarantee a job. Right. They guarantee a job because the thing they teach in the school.
Right.
Okay. With one state, first, how is the scholarship? And then I'll come to what they study there.
The scholarship?
Scholarship. What's the possibility of a person like you with hardship and all that to get a scholarship?
I was probably, I can say, lucky enough to have a $10 job at that time. Dr. Ralph Kumler put me in a City of Detroit water treatment plant.
Okay.
So they were doing a pilot training for the testing of water. So my job was collect the samples, take it to the lab every day from Jefferson plant to the Livonia. There is a testing lab every day, and then analyze the results in the
office. But did they have good scholarship program?
I think Wayne State, especially being an automotive industry, being in downtown, that's the only university right in the center of the downtown. It has a lot of focus, especially industrial and mechanical engineering side.
Okay.
I think they do.
Go ahead.
If I may just chime in.
Yeah.
Wayne State actually has what is called as the Michigan Promise, and which means that parents who earn less than $70,000, if their kids want to go to Wayne State, their education is for free.
Great.
So it is a very, very good
thing
to do for Wayne State.
I see.
But going a little back to Sunny, Sunny's whole life has been dedicated to education.
Uh-huh.
Okay, it was just a few, you know, information about him. He's a very modest person, so I will take the opportunity. During the COVID, he has adopted 25 families of orphans, people that have died of COVID.
That's great.
And educating them from kindergarten to high school in private education, and he's paying the funds.
That's a noble.
You know, for $25,000, he just gave a check to one of the places that was needing hurricane, etc.
Red Cross, American Red Cross.
That's great.
And so just to get a little on that, at Wayne State we need him because he is so educated. He's a Wayne State alumna.
Mm-hmm.
And his heart is to get our minority students, both African American.
That's all I'm going to come to that.
And
too.
Thank you.
But we have six university advertised with us. We have LTU, we have Wayne Community College District, we have Madonna, we have Detroit Mercy. We have a lot.
Right.
And we invite all the president, and I invite them, and we talk. And they talk about what the student study in that university.
Right.
If you could meet, and if you could help Dr. Kumar, Wayne State, what they are famous for?
Wayne State is actually, engineering is pretty good.
That's great.
Of course, automotive. Okay. We are automotive city. Engineering is very strong. And also the law school and the med school. Med school is one of the top school, if I can say. And the largest class size in the country, too.
Okay. So that's the medical. The med, okay. Is that for nursing? Or for the physician.
Nursing is excellent too. It's one of the foremost nursing schools in the state.
I see.
And it also the allied, like PA school, mm-hmm. is one of the finest.
That's right.
And the pharmacy too, actually.
School of pharmacy too. So they have so many things.
Yeah, so many things.
And honestly, when you meant the med and all that, people, they get the job before even graduate.
That's right.
It's the same like, you know.
Yeah.
Winnet State and the location too. And I know a lot of people who go to Winnet State and all that. And Michigan and that area, Detroit, suburbs of Detroit, are multi-ethnic minorities.
That's right.
You're going to see the Indian, the Middle Eastern, the African American, the Asian, the Latino, and all that. And I see Winnet State is the same as reflecting the community.
That's right.
Tell me more about Winnet State and that diversity in that school.
You know, it's always been like that. Even when we were in school,
yes.
in the masters, actually. Uh-huh. I'm talking about the 30 years ago, we used to be about 600 kids from India. Just from India.
Wow.
When you go out, we used to see, people used to joke about it in the Durai apartments, actually.
Oh, yeah?
That's no longer there.
Yes.
So every floor, if you go in the lift, you see the different curry smell. So because it's apartment complex, used to be apartment complex. So
yes.
It's been said, always been multi-ethnic.
And you know, it's comfortable when you see multi-ethnic minority. If Middle Eastern or Indian go to that school, he doesn't see any different because he knows other culture too.
That's right.
So they could work with each other.
Uh-huh.
And that mosaic of the culture, it helped a lot of students and it helped a lot of parents to send their kids to this kind of school. Dr. Kumar, you have a lot of experience and within Winnet State University. You've been a trustee, you know, there and all that. Tell me more, the trustee. Is that election every year? And I'm going to come to Sonny with that.
So there are eight trustees who we call the Board of Governors.
I see, okay.
And Michigan, the state of Michigan has three schools that have elected members. University of Michigan, Michigan State, and Wayne State.
I see.
So these are also funded by the state.
Okay.
Now, Wayne State University, out of the eight that are there, uh-huh. board of members, every 2 years, two get elected.
I see.
So it's an eight-year term.
Wow, long term.
Long term, which
yes.
gives us the ability to understand and do the right things we need to do for the university.
I see. Sonny, how's the campaign going? You have two people, right? You and another person.
Yeah.
Okay.
Actually, it's a two positions, four people.
Oh, two positions, four people. I see.
Actually, total nine people running. So two Democrats, two Republicans, then you have a Green Party, then other candidates also there. Total nine.
But how many seats?
Two seats.
Two seats. So four people or six people running for the two seats.
Two seats. Right.
So how's the election? How's the campaign going?
You know, I believe in God, but I want to put 100% of my effort.
Yes.
And that's what I'm doing right now, every day.
Yeah.
I'm putting 100% effort. Mm-hmm. I want to. I'm enjoying actually going out. Made so many friends
yes.
like yourself. Great people, and I'm enjoying. I'm meeting people. I want to see, you know, talk to the people. See what I can do. What their concerns. That's what I've been doing.
I see. Are you reaching, as we said, Winnet State as mosaic of many other ethnic minority? Are you reaching to other ethnic minorities so they could know about you, about your mission? And to work with your campaign?
I'm trying, actually, wherever I can get a connections. I was, last week, in fact, actually, I was in...
I met you in an event, and you were all over the people.
Exactly. I didn't stop at that
yes.
event. I was going around and talking uh-huh. to the people.
Which
that's
is
what
excellent.
I do.
Excellent.
That's what I do. You know what? It's been about 14 months since I launched my campaign.
Okay.
Everybody says, you know what? I'm the most hardworking person. And that's what I do in my life. That's what I do. I'm doing in the politics, too.
Yeah.
So I don't believe in getting something for free. I want to earn it.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what I'm doing. I want to make sure the person other side know who I am. And then I want them to vote for the person rather than looking at the party or looking at the other side. So I've been doing it. I think I'm confident that it's going to work.
Dr. Kumar, can you add a little bit to more? Yeah, I know you know Sonny very well. What he's doing, what's his mission of running for the board?
He's one of the finest person who deserves to be on the Board of Governors. Mm-hmm. He's the most hardworking candidate that I've seen so far. Apart from me, maybe.
Apart, that's the true statement.
Yes.
And the thing that he brings to the board is the ethnicity, the ability to recognize that people who have come from beginnings that were harder have the potential to rise to the extreme of what he is. He's a very, very successful business person, but his heart is there to give to people.
Great, great.
And he, and like me, we come from India, and the Middle Eastern community is, it's like our brethren.
Absolutely, yeah.
We, you know, they, the Middle Eastern, like you said, you know, you love Indian food.
Absolutely.
The same thing with us. We love the Middle Eastern culture.
A lot of culture with the same.
Exchange.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah.
He would empathize with every person in the school. Because being Indian, the Indian community is well known. Middle Eastern, he has experience with them. His partner is Middle Eastern. So there is that connection that our students and our community needs with the Board of Governors for the universities. Because guess what? There are limited positions that are available, medical school, law school, and others.
Yes.
And our minority kids need that.
You need to get on board.
Role model who is there
to
help them understand how best to come up in their lives and reach their dreams.
I see.
He is the epitome of
that. You know, I want to add a little bit to that one. With my experience, I didn't have that. So my policy is, you know what? I missed that one, but I built myself. So the next generation doesn't have to do that.
Great, great.
So something is there.
Yeah. Is that statewide election?
It is a statewide.
So everywhere. And we broadcast not just to the whole state of Michigan.
Yeah.
We broadcast in every state in the nation.
Right.
And a lot of the people, they watch us, majority, they are Middle Eastern. If it's in Michigan or from Alaska to Hawaii.
Right.
Broadcast in every state. But what's your message, especially to the Middle Eastern community? Why they should vote for you?
So, as I said again, I am running for next generation kids. I want, you know what, I've been in this country for the last 20 years. I have an American dream, and I'm successful having that. I want to keep that American dream for the next generation. So I want to make sure that especially the Middle Eastern kids, Indian kids, everybody, I want to make sure that they have a support they need at the campus.
Yes.
I'm sure the schools can be affordable for them. I want to make sure the schools are affordable for them.
Yes.
And my goal is, you know what, I don't want to limit myself just to the Wayne State. I want to work across the board within Michigan, other schools also.
Excellent.
I want to make sure that these kids have some help.
Yes.
And I want to jump in. I've been doing it, you know, without the position also. I've been doing it. If anybody help, doctor, like a Dr. Kumar, I jump on it. You know, if somebody needs a help, let me see what I can do,
Great.
You know, how I can reach, what can we do. So I've been always doing it, and I want to make sure that I can continue to do that.
And Sonny, having Dr. Kumar next to you, it makes a huge difference.
Big difference.
The community loves Dr. Kumar because Dr. Kumar contributes so much to the Middle Eastern community.
Right.
He's one of us.
Right.
Absolutely.
So for when his support, I think it's more than 70% of your winning coming from Dr. Kumar.
So just want to let you know my experience. I've been traveling, Doc. I didn't tell you, but I've been traveling. I said, are you running against Dr. Kumar? I said, no. Dr. Kumar has a tumor. Yes, I will be working with the Dr. Kumar.
Yes.
I want to join Dr. Kumar.
Yeah.
I said, okay, then you got my vote.
Yeah. Well,
then you got my vote.
Sure.
So I have that experience in the public, actually.
Well, good luck in your campaign.
Thank you.
And Dr. Kumar, thanks again for coming. You make me always happy when I see you.
The mutual feeling, Wally, you are one of the greatest person I know, honestly, from my heart.
Thank you.
And the Middle Eastern community really is part and parcel of our genetic makeup.
And they love you.
And
whenever I go and I say, Dr. Kumar, oh yeah, of course, Dr. Kumar. So,
and you know, Wally,
yes.
If we minorities get together, we are a majority.
Absolutely.
We have to remember that. Support each other, because America is the only country that gives us that opportunity to be who we are, and so we can bring back what America needs for us to work and make it a great nation.
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Because a country is who the people are.
Yes.
And we,
I'm with you 100%.
As I always tell people, we came here to be Americans.
Yes, and for a better future for our children.
Yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, Sonny, good luck in your campaign.
Thank you.
And I said, with Dr. Kumar, you have a great chance to win.
Thank you. Well, with you, Wally, we have a great chance.
Yeah, exactly, Wally. And I want you to know that you have a second friend now, too.
Second one. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
That was my interview with, of course, Dr. Kumar, my friend Dr. Kumar, and with Sonny. Sonny Reddy, when you go and vote, and please go and vote, no matter who you vote, go and vote. That's most important thing, the message that MEA and their friend, that they're going to give you, that to go and vote, and please go and vote. But again, when you go and vote, you have to remember who you're voting for. Sonny, he is an ethnic person. Sonny, he's been with the Middle Eastern community. I see him in an event and all that. He understands our culture. He like our food, of course, and he like the custom and all that. So that's what you need. You need in a school somebody to understand this culture, because each culture acts different. And us as a Middle Eastern community, just like the Indian, our brother in India, we have our culture, we have our custom, we know the thing we wear and all that. So please, when you go and vote for somebody that understand you, understand your culture, understand your family and how the family work. So please vote and vote for Sonny on November 5th. There's about 6-7 of them. So make sure that you go for Sonny Reddy. Sonny Reddy on November 5th. Thanks for watching and good night.